How many of you understand what I am sharing? So you need to be in a space of listening, so that it is not just hearing, it is not intellectual class. See, when I speak about some concept, it should become your muscle memory, it should become your bio memory. For that to happen, you need to be in integrity. See, the word, each one of you should have that kind of a power of word. That will happen only when you practice integrity. Integrity is Kalabhairava Puja. What is? See, maintaining time, time is Kala. Time is the lord of, the Kala is the lord of time. When you are in integrity with the time, Kala listens to you, Kala speaks through you, the Kala's energy expresses through you. I tell you, there was a time I was also like this only, no punctuality, nothing. As I said, 24 hours I'll work, so 20 hours I'll work per day. But I'll come whenever, my life has become so disorganized. Anybody can come and demand my time. But now, after this January 1st, when I started declaring integrity and started living it, now even people know, only this time you can meet. People also start adjusting their routine as per my integrity. Stapati is waiting now. Morning he came and I gave him the brief about to our Stapati, means our Swamis.
They don't know who's a Stapati.
Stapati means the traditional architect who built temples and halls and all. The next, the Nityanand Sabha we are going to build, that huge IA Sabha, will be just like a Meenakshi Amman's 1000-pillar mandapam, with full of the traditional carving and that kind of work. See, when we built all these hall, we were in the survival mode. We just need to survive. We need a roof on our head. But now, all you guys are blessed and God has blessed us. We can do little beautifully, expressing the tradition. I always wanted all these halls to be with the traditional pillars and traditional look and everything. So that Sabha we are going to do, the traditional architect is here. So I was giving instruction to our Swamis. Even they know, 10:15 class Swamiji said, so we have to be here on sharp 9:30. Only then we will get at least half an hour from Swamiji. Otherwise we have to wait till the next break. They all now adjust their calendar. Now my whole life has become not just productive. I tell you, you see, the Vaksiddhi and all, like, it came by enlightenment. That is different. But the whole day has become now order. It is an order. You may not even need to bother about enlightenment. Just live integrity. You will have the Vaksiddhi, means your words will become reality. Clear? Just with integrity, with the time, Kala Bhairava. Make them take the oath. Minutes. But I am not going to leave. It's already 10:30, 15 minutes. I think we wasted. But this is not a waste. I'll insist. Even if one person comes 1 minute late, I'll talk about it for 15 minutes. That is the way you will come to the space of listening. And one more thing, I take the responsibility for each one of you. I am responsible for each one of you experiencing it. I declared in the beginning of the session itself. Nobody is going to question me. But the space we hold, we have given a word. That is the only way we will become sensitive to ourselves and things around us. See, if I don't honor the word, even I am not integrated with the word, I will be on time. Even if that I am not integrated, then how will I fulfill the word I am giving you? I will liberate you when you leave the body. How will I fulfill these big, big words? It is my integrity. Here is a statement. Even in that words, I am integrated. I will fulfill it. I will do it. Same way, all your plan for future is a big plan. I will have 100 crore wealth, $1 billion, big house, car, All that is a word you are giving to yourself. Am I right? Each one of you guys give big, big words for you, na? If you can't maintain integrity here for a few minutes, how are you going to maintain all those with integrity? How are you going to make all that as reality? You think some lottery will win and you will get a easy money? No. See, I tell you, in tradition we have a word called Upanishad, means waiting with the space of listening for master. This is the exact translation of the word Upanishad. Sitting with the space of listening. Only 2 minutes before, if you settle down, sit with the space of listening. Because the first statement I am going to make is always the essence of the whole day session. Understand? When I come, I open the mouth, the first statement I am going to make, that is the essence of the whole session or that whole day. If you are not in the space of listening for that first statement, over. That whole day is a waste for you now. You get this idea, this tattva is Sangha. Understand? When group of people, more than one person, stands up for these four principles, you form a Sangha, you are the Sangha, that's all. Yesterday we worked on inner, actual inner image. Am I right? The word you gave it to you about you, which forms the basis for your whole personality. Mamakara, inner image. Am I right? Today, we will be working on the root patterns of outer image and others' image and life image. Listen, listen, listen. The words you utter towards others and towards life in you, which forms the basis of your understanding about life. For example, if you feel, if you are given a word, life always cheats me, over. If that is the word you gave it to you as a basis root pattern, then you will always feel your brother gets more from your mother, your sister gets more from your father, you don't get anything. How many of you have this feeling? Can you raise your hand? You will always feel life is cheating you. Life just cheats you. Understand? When you think life cheats you, life cheats you because life obeys you. Listen, this is the statement of the day. When you decide life cheats you, life does cheat you, because life obeys you. After all this attack, persecution, suffering and everything, I tell you very clearly, life is bliss. I never felt life cheated me. Life has cheated me. The pattern with which you build your relationship with others and the life, we will catch that root pattern. Listen. Whatever is the root pattern on which, in Sanskrit we have a word called Moola Vasana. Moolya Vasana. Moola Vasana means root pattern. Moolya Vasana means capital pattern. Both are one and the same. Only with the capital you can start the business. Same way, only with this capital, the root pattern, your pattern starts getting built up. If your root pattern is life cheats me, I am not given what I am qualified of, I tell you, life will be doing exactly that because life obeys you. It brings you the situation, principles, people, circumstances who will exactly cheat you because that is what you wanted. Sometimes people come and tell me, Swamiji, why I am always abused? Any relationship I start, they abuse me and run away. Because you are waiting and calling, oh, abusive people, please come here and be part of my life. Abusive people, ihagacha, ihagacha, ihatishta, ihatishta. You invoke them. You invite them. The space you are carrying, if it is waiting for abusal, then naturally you are going to be inviting, attracting that kind of people. You are walking, talking, breathing in the space of waiting for abuse to happen. Then what will happen? That will only happen. Life is a powerful self-fulfilling mechanism. Self-fulfilling mechanism. Understand, today we are going to work on three subjects. Your actual inner image. Yesterday we worked, today I am going to take you to the deeper level. Second, your outer image, how you project yourself to others. Third, your image about others and life. Listen, listen, listen. It is not Anyakara, not others' image about you. No, your image about others and life. See, when your image about others and life, if that is not really balanced, conscious, how many of you are getting it? Your image about others and the world, swa anyakara. Understand? Swa anyakara. Getting it? You don't need to use the memorize Sanskrit word. I'm just telling you the Sanskrit word so that the language is kept alive, the tradition is kept alive. Get it? Catch it? Listen? Now I wanted you to catch this point. Listen. When you have the wrong image, idea about life and others, you feel so powerless. You create a new image for you, which is a substitute for your actual inner image, and go on projecting that to others. That is ahankara. How many of you got it? I'll repeat. I'll take you step by step now. You are mamakara, you are ahamkara, means your image about yourself and your image you project to others and your image about life and others. All these three are intertwined. Listen. At a vulnerable and intense, incomplete moment of the past, sometime when you are confronted, attacked, in extreme conflict, your inner image, which arised out of disempowering statement, disempowering cognition, powerlessness. Out of that, your inner image takes shape. Then, this is the moment you are faced with a survival threat. Usually, only in the survival threat you will be imbalanced. You will be in extreme confrontation. In that perceived survival threat, along with the disempowering cognition you have about you, two things will happen simultaneously. Listen. Two things will happen simultaneously. One, you get the disempowering, means making you the statement which makes you powerless about you. Then, you also create the statement which makes you powerless, disempowering about others and life. How many of you are getting it? It is not that you only make a statement, I am a stupid fool, victim. No, you also make a statement, all these fellows are out to attack me, cheat me, exploit me. How many of you recognize you made this kind of statement also to you? Listen. In order to survive and escape from your perceived confrontation and suffocation of that moment. See, when you are completely suffocated and confronted, and that moment, you have to survive now. In order to escape from that moment, incompletion, you create a pseudo-identity. You redefine your inner image in a pseudo way. I know it's a very serious Vedantic truths. Please understand, it's a very important truth, but if you understand this, you will understand life is a dream. You are playing with it. You grab to alternative compensating cognition. Alternative compensating cognition. Understand this word. See, for example, somebody is chasing you at the age of 4. You run and hide yourself in the bathroom, but you are not even able to lock the bathroom to protect yourself. So the situation is such, you already gave a word to you, I am a loser, I am a victim, I am going to be destroyed. This is the cognition. But finally that guy comes and breaks the bathroom door and tries to pick you up. Then you give the word to him, word about him. Life is out there to get me. Life is here to cheat me, exploit me. So in this powerless moment, you create alternative compensating cognition for survival. You show you are a very strong guy without making you, without giving that word to you, you will give that word to others. Hey! What are you trying to do? You redefine your inner image without actually redefining inside, just to project outside and scream for survival reason. That is ahankara. And you show you are a courageous person. If that guy runs away in that moment, that's it. You come to the conclusion you are a courageous person and go on projecting you are a courageous person to the world, never trying to repair the base statement you already gave it to you. You are a weak victim. Without repairing it, you start living with this alternative compensating cognition. That's the right term for ahankara.